Glasgow made up for not inventing football by creating Celtic, Rangers and the Hampden Roar. The city also has a strong schools and club rugby tradition. And men and women with the leisure and energy to play sport, as well as just watch it. Bellahousen Sports Centre, the prototype for several to be built in the city, was regularly used by 7,000 members in 1970. For getting away from the crowds and just walking about among trees and flowers and greenery, Glasgow offers a selection of 62 parks and recreation areas. The Botanic Gardens at the city's west end. Glasgow grew rich on the tides of the Clyde. The river itself grew dirtier and dirtier. Strict controls and cleaning up measures are now exercised by the Clyde River Purification Board. And by 1980, the river water will be pure enough to support fish once again. Its banks also will be transformed. Ocean-going shipping will by then be operating chiefly in the deeper waters of the Firth of Clyde. Glasgow docks, Queen's, Prince's, Kingston, will be filled in and the recreated land attractively and usefully deployed. The grim lines of warehouses and waterfront factories will be demolished and walkways constructed so that for the first time in 100 years, the people of Glasgow will have the visual and amenity benefits of the river freely accessible. Time and the river. The river changes and the next generation grows. The teachers of 1980. Langside College of Further Education. By 1980, as many as 24,000 men and women from all over the west of Scotland region will be receiving full-time education at the city's universities and colleges. Part of a rapidly developing educational precinct near the city centre, Glasgow College of Building, and the young men whose skills will build the new houses and roads, offices and factories, hospitals, colleges and schools for their children, for the next generation. A city with a future as big as its past. A city of fighters whose response to a challenge is usually bigger than the challenge itself. A city whose energy has perhaps too much in the recent past been frustrated and corrupted into violence by apparently insurmountable social problems. But an energy which today is expressing itself, rediscovering itself through the dynamism of change, difficult but necessary change towards planned freedom, mobility, a more happily coordinated and prosperous society. There's a lot to be done, but the city and its people are doing it. Reaching out for Glasgow
1980. Summer breeze and brilliant light. Only love she's Days break wondering.